How y'all doing? I want to welcome y'all to Strawberry Space, where we discuss transgender-related topics.
Thank you, God. Thank you, God, for allowing me to get out safe. Now, if you could let me just make it to the police station so I could get help. Just thank you, Lord. Thank you so much, Lord. I'm not a tramp, okay? I promise you, I'm not a tramp. I got a pussy. And I could show you if you just let me show you, please.
I know you do.
James.
Bitch.
So hey y'all, welcome to my YouTube channel. My name is Sierra, but if you're new here and you're not subscribed, I have a tattoo on my face of a strawberry. So my homegirls and people call me Strawberry. Welcome to Strawberry Space. I'm a black trans woman and I dive into a plethora of transgender topics for trans men, trans women in the urban African-American community and, you know, white, Asian, Indian, anything. So I'm here to give you a buffet. So grab your plate because we are going to discuss all the trans controversy in society. Starting with that was a snippet of Transgender Tubi movie Trans Me Reloaded. It was really good. It wasn't the best in organization. I give it a 2 out of 5. I do recommend you to watch it. So let's get into all the juicy tea in the T sector of the LGBT community. So first on the docket, we have a triple entendre of these black female entertainers, socialite rappers, and influencers. That's all, what about the children? What about the children? And how trans and gay people are having an agenda. But we finna run it down piece by piece, person by person, because, honey, didn't Sukiyana twerk on that guy for her music video? Oh, yes, she did. He was underage, too. What about the children? Didn't Ari... son, Yoshan, his iPad number leaked. Now, mind you, the little boy is only 4 years old. People was texting him, hey, what's up? Hey, yo, nephew. She went on live about it. She deleted it, so I couldn't really screenshot it, saying that y'all are weird. Why would y'all grown men text a little boy? But, you know, someone had sex back. Well, what about the women? I don't know. That's cool. He can have them a little girlfriend. You know, matter of fact, y'all need to, you know, buy him this and buy him that. And child, you know, when he grow up, I wonder what type of mother I'd be if I just see the girl walking around and I just be like, hey, what's up? And I mean, she was sexualizing her son and that's a minor. Is it, you know, a reach? Yes. But is it the same when it's only in the straight community? And let's not forget Miss Pep Rally Princess Erica Banks throwing it back on a middle school student, twerking on them, and she's in her 20s. So did we see the double standard here? Did we see the hypocrisy? These women are, you know, who your daughters are looking at, icons in a Gen Z, you know, era, millennial time frame. I just wanted to showcase that because me and my homegirls, the trans girlies, you know, the girls are the girls are the girls are the girls, the femme queens, was kind of like, why do we have to step on eggshells with our, you know, message and just, you know, present ourselves in a positive role model when they don't do the same, but it's kind of looked at as just them being authentically them in ratchet culture. So moving on. So yeah, y'all know Black Twitter is infamous for dragging any and everybody. So they pulled up into the yearbooks and pulled some major receipts on 1977 with this man. This drag queen looks a mess. I just want to say, Mr. Bill Lee. And this just isn't anybody. Fast forward back to now, 2023. This is the governor of Tennessee. So to keep on the hypocrisy train, this is the person who signed off on the Tennessee drag bill of 2023. So he's basically saying like, look, We accept you for who you are, just not in public and not in front of our children. You cannot. It's a crime now to perform drag in front of children in public places. No more drag brunch. No more LGBTQ hour. It's going to be some criminal offenses behind this. Kentucky, Florida, Texas. You know, everybody is joining in on the Oklahoma and in agreeance. The governor of Minnesota, however, made a statement about it. But you have certain people like, you know, Fantasia Royale, Stasha, Sanchez. They are like, listen, you're messing up my coin. I'm Miss Continental. I do beauty pageants all over the world. Now I gotta stop what I'm doing. And you just hindering my bag because now I can't go to certain cities that probably, you know, where the bag at? Where the bag at? You know, the money-making places. Michelle, the Beyonce impersonator, you know, is all to a halt. But it's kind of like, what is the reasoning here? Why would you target a, you know, a certain genre of people, like as if they're harming people? Now, in my defense, because I'm fair, I have seen drag queens in children's faces, two instances, one on The Simpsons and two on Sesame Street. But aside from that, is it really that detrimental? Like, is it really that serious? You have some people whom, you know what I'm saying, see themselves in people on TV and need representation as well. You have RuPaul, and some of these places that they're talking about are predominantly nightclubs with alcohol, so you have to be over 18 anyway. So I don't really know what the problem was, but I just found it a cackle and a key that they looked him up and saw him in a dress as well, and for free, might I add. So what goes around comes around. So we know trans women can be performers too, but that was more toward the drag queen sector of Strawberry Space. So we're here inclusive. We love everybody and we talk about it all, even though, you know, there's a difference between drag queens and trans women. And I'm glad, you know, I was able to showcase that for a lot of people, because a lot of people just consider them all in the same category as cross-dressers and men. So in Canada, speaking of drag queens being different than trans women, they have put out that a size Z implanted breastplate upon a man makes her trans. There is a teacher whom has been put out on leave because they caught her out and about outside of her job, you know, in a totally different outfit. She was dressed as a man. So I'm going to respect her pronouns. And then she comes to school in front of the students teaching of all subjects, wood shop. Now, you know, there ain't nothing but horny men in there in this high school. And they said that it was inappropriate. They had a petition signed by the parents. And they feel like they had her removed from the school. Thank God with pay. So I'm going to say she's trans. We don't know. But in my opinion, I feel like if they saw her around the corner at a local Walmart with no hair, no makeup, or no, you know, breasts, I mean, that just speaks for itself. But, you know, you could self-identify. This is kind of a setback for the trans community, because I feel like a lot of people would feel as though we just have a costume that we just take on and off and it's a caricature, but it's not. She knows she wrong for that, and I just wish she would just move on and go with her, you know, path that she believes in her heart. The breast size is really, really big. It is giving, you know, Mary bimbo look-ish, but if that's what she want to go for, I just hope that nobody sues her, but she is currently fighting her scandal. So, child, speaking of dressing up, because he tried to speak for a community of gender non-conforming and non-binary people who might, I also add, could be trans too. And I also want to give a little history lesson. Now they're trying to say it's called cishead for the biological men and women watching this. Jeffree Star made a statement. So I'm going to play that. We're going to discuss it and take a look.
Question for Mike. What's my gender? I just remember Mike trying to cock block me and Andrew Schultz and wasn't keeping it real.
Oh, wait, did I fuck this up in the past?
Yeah.
Can we open this for me?
Gotcha. No. You identify as he / he.
Fuck yeah, bro. All
right, was that...
hey, fuck yeah, bro.
Was that right?
Yeah, of course it is. I'm a dude. I love makeup. I love fashion. I've been doing this for so long. Now these terms did not exist when I was a kid.
Do you fuck with them or no?
With what?
The terms.
No. I think half of it's fucking stupid. But no one wants to ever say that.
Will you get in trouble for saying it?
I don't care anymore.
You're beyond...
But I never cared, yeah. I've been canceled 10 times. You guys talk about cancel culture all the time. Yeah.
What did Mike say in the past?
What was it on the podcast?
Oh, no. You guys were just not... Like, it was just a funny moment when Andrew asked, what was my gender?
Yeah.
And Andrew asked you guys, who's now my client. I do his merchandise, which is so funny.
I didn't tell all the other bullshit, I think.
What other bullshit?
The they and them.
Yeah.
And all that extra shit that we added during the pandemic because everyone was so bored on their fucking houses. They just started to make up more shit and
more
shit.
More stuff.
Yeah. That's where the conservatives like me because I'm just real.
Yeah, you have a conservative vibe to you.
You're not they and them. You're trans, you're male or you're female.
And you're standing on that.
People get so mad when I say that. How are you a they? What the fuck does that mean? It's stupid is what it is.
Yeah.
But you need someone like me that looks like me to say it. Because if you say it, it turns into you're homophobic. You hate trans people. You hate gays. And it's just how you feel. You don't hate anyone. You just think it's stupid.
So I'm not going to lie. I thought she was trans when I first saw her. Now I know that, you know, she's a him. So now Jeffree Star is just, you know, a flamboyant guy who likes to, you know, tamper and dibble and dabble. There's nothing wrong with that. What I find interesting was he said that I think people can relate to me because I'm a conservative man. What now? You're conservative? What part of Jeffree Star is conservative? I just want to let that sink in. And two, in addition to that, you can't speak upon our behalf of people just because you're in a community, because you're not in that sector of it. We here on Strawberry Space talk about trans men and women because I'm trans. My friends are trans. My subscribers are either cis people who are allies of trans people or trans people themselves. I can't speak on lesbians or gay men because I don't know their struggle. You know what I'm saying? And we all have the rainbow origin, but you know, you just don't want to step on your toes. So I think it was very careless for him to say that he thinks it's stupid when he indeed wants acceptance, because it's so funny how he's going to trauma bomb with these people over us, and then the moment the cameras cut and they leave, what do you think they're gonna do? They're gonna talk about him too. But anything for a pick me, child. So we here at Strawberry Space want the feeling to be reciprocated, right? So when our allies stand up for us, we stand up for them. So Lotto and Cardi B, you know, have openly accepted Tokyo Styles with open arms before she was a guy, you know, and then now she's transitioned to a beautiful, blossoming woman, and she be slaying. I mean, edges be on fleek. However, since she was currently... you know, Cardi B stylist. She was previously Nicki Minaj's stylist. There is a little tension there. They're just tearing our poor little girlies up. Now, me and my barb, I don't know. Sometimes I be feeling Nicki, sometimes I be feeling Cardi. But with Armand Wiggins, he is a, you know, YouTube blogger, a celebrity influencer, was dragging Lotto through the mud. We can't act like, you know, we haven't noticed before. Armand is definitely, you know, transphobic. With Cardi B, though, she's getting attacked as well. And we just want to see how we can help because, you know, we can't save everybody now. But I did a Secret Society movie review where two cisgender women had played trans women. So now it's been word on the curb that her and Meg Thee Stallion, with their WAP rendition hairstyle, have been inquiring to their producers about doing a BAPS remake. You know, the movie back in the day with the big hair with Halle Berry and the old white man. Yeah, that. They don't have a problem with Meg, despite the whole Tory incident. They have a problem with Cardi because, you know, she called black women roaches, and they feel like she shouldn't be in black women's business because she's not African-American herself. She's Hispanic. So I just want to say, you know, it's just crazy. It's just a movie. I mean, it's so wrong to just, you know, let her be embark on, you know, black history. It's crazy. It's crazy how, you know, when it's a trans person, you know, the depiction could be anybody. And they'll leave the audience members asking, is that a woman? Is that a real woman? And this is not just a person who, you know what I'm saying, is heterosexual, biological, cisgender, got ovaries, got the periods, got the pregnancies, and could carry the baby and not in the community, disregarded the whole cast of Pose, and that'd be okay. But when it's someone of the African-American community, it's different. And they just don't want her to be in, you know, any type of affiliation with the movie. I also believe, Strawberry Space, that I don't know if it was her son or her daughter that was on TikTok. What really pissed a lot of people off, what she did was she spoke on the two men that were doing the mukbang reviews, dancing in, you know, predominantly white areas. And she was saying, like, you know, don't cancel their money, but I guess the people in the African-American community looked at it like it's not just entertainment with them dancing. It's kind of like, you know, back in the day when house slaves and, you know, the field slaves would come in and perform, you know, for white people as a form, like as they were eating of, you know, make me laugh and just, you know, stuff like that. So when she spoke on that, people felt like she could not compete, where she couldn't compare. So I just don't feel like, you know, they care for her anyway. Since, you know, that, and then Love & Hip Hop, and then she just keeps digging a deeper hole with herself, not releasing an album, having her fans very conflicted.
So this is upsetting people enough to the point that they are trying to ban Big Groove. Now, for some black people, this goes deeper than the eye could see. It's reminding them of minstrels. So if you're not familiar with that, those were the white people who would dress up in blackface, who would dance mocking black people to entertain white people. So they would even talk like what they felt black people talk like. They would dance like black people, you know, anything that's stereotypical of a black person during that time, that's what they would do. And so to some black people, that's what these two guys remind them of. One person said, instead of getting mad, I'm gonna educate. The reason black Americans specifically do not like the big dancing gorilla dude and chicken boy is because they are performing minstrelsy. Minstrels in America were people in blackface or a black person with darkened makeup that act like a effing clown for the entertainment of white people. We are past that. Stop trying to take us back. So this is where people get upset with Cardi B, because Cardi B went live and she was actually taken up for these men. And a lot of people felt like, listen, who are you to speak on what's going on with our culture?
So video credits from that. We're from B with the T, and we love our female allies to the death of us here at Strawberry Space, along with our male allies, you know, Tusi. He also is, you know, standing with, you know, the LGBT community, stating that, you know, on Twitter, being gay is not an insult. He stood with Eric and Tay and, you know, Saucy Santana and said, listen, it's wrong for y'all to come at them. And, you know, he stood by the trans girlies too with his fine ass, even though he got a girlfriend though. By the way, Eric and Tay is who he stood by, and they said that they were together, but some tea for y'all says he stood by him. He is Nicki Minaj's new hairstylist, and what was crazy was that his girlfriend told him deliberately that the moment he does a song with her, it's over. Ooh, can y'all say Insecure? So if y'all don't know 2C, y'all, he's the one who sings the song Sapiosexual. The song Worth It by YK Osiris, we thought was, you know, another ally. He was actually someone who just got exposed and caught. So, you know, the people here at Strawberry Space are trans women and men are like, wait a minute, caught with who? Because when we Google, we say it is by his baby mama that he caught being a woman with a man. But then, you know, the search results say trans woman. The poor boy deleted all his pictures. And we need to know, like, who would you in bed with a man or a trans woman? It's so crazy and sad nowadays that when you hear man, you don't even know who we're talking about. And it's imperative because you remember when he got out of jail, Bobby Schmurder was in bed with the man, and we thought it was a trans woman, you know, since he's from the tri-state area in New York, and he was actually in bed with an actual man. The boy on Twitter came out and, you know, said something. So we just don't know what's going on. We're going to give you an update on that. You know, we love YK Osiris, okay? But we just want, you know, his baby mama to know that that's not a read. And it's sad that for some African-American women that they are very transphobic. And the first thing they're going to do to emasculate a man is come for his sexuality. There's nothing like you and I. So from the one that bought you Sweetest Taboo, Kiss of Life, All Ordinary Love, Smooth Operator, and Soldier of Love, icon, ladies and gentlemen of Strawberry Space, Sade. They say she's making a recap this year in 2023 and is set to release new music. But the question the trans men and women of Strawberry Space have to add is she going to take Isaac Watts with her? Oh, y'all don't know who that is? Child, that's her trans son. He does music too. He's married. He's been really ducked off. He don't let nobody in her business as she. But I mean, she's been kind of hiding him for a long time though. I mean, not to say that she doesn't love him, but I mean, she just hasn't, you know, had it out there to the general public. So, you know, he supported her. He bought the shirts. He went on tour the first time in 2001. So we're just here to see what is it going to give the second time around.
You look great.
You know.
Dapper and
y'all
sharp.
Y'all know how we do. You know.
Are you excited to see yourself on the big screen?
I'm very, very much.
Yeah?
Nah,
look. So how's it feel?
My favorite camera, like. They know I was in that camera. Like, I would go in front of the camera even if it was somewhere else. So.
Like, dude, that's be in the camera, confessions and everything, or what?
They make me look so good. Well, again, this camera is my brother.
Okay.
They're going to correct you. They're going to let you know. They're not going to have you looking. So they've gave me the confidence.
I love that.
Me being trans, all the confidence to be just like this.
And yeah. You are quite handsome, very much quite handsome.
Oh,
so the camera loves you as much as you love that camera.
Well, a big round of applause to Dorian. He is going to be the first trans man on the True Color Network. Now, the show he's going to be on is season 2 of LGBTQ Baddies. It's kind of like a spinoff if you get the pattern. Zeus, Dosh Network, now that's TV, the whole spiel. So, you know, we're excited for him, and he looks handsome doing it. Now, speaking of now that's TV, y'all want to hear some real tea? I mean, I'm not trying to be shady, but somebody invited me on a closed group on Facebook of the network for South Central Baddies on season 3, Sky, who is beautiful, by the way. You know, melanated queen. Someone found pictures of her pre-transition, and baby, sis was fine. So I'm going to play them clips, and we're going to talk about how juicy she was before the hormones. Now, sis, if you're watching this, and I mean no disrespect or harm when I say this, though, so don't come for me. It's a compliment, okay? You are a gorgeous, beautiful black trans woman, but as a man, well, before, you know, you were, you know, self-identified as a woman, you could have got the business. You hear me? Made a business. So now tackling every other elephant in the room, we have to bring up y'all's, and when I say y'all, I mean cisgender women and men's transphobia towards trans people when it comes to trying to figure out whether somebody is a man or not. I mean, what difference does it really make? Are you going to stop being their friend, stop listening to their music, stop watching their YouTube channel, stop subscribing, stop, you know, being their fan favorite on TV? What does it do for y'all? I mean, really, it's just, it's foul, it's disgusting, and it really is showing your true colors to the people who is actually unapologetically trans. So I just want to say that. You know, and let that be clear on Strawberry Space.
During a transgender woman killed in Milwaukee, police found Cache Henderson shot to death inside a burning building near 29th and Villard Sunday morning. Overnight, police arrested a 33-year-old in Winnebago County in connection to Henderson's death. 12 News' Nick Borer is live at the LGBT Community Center near MLK and Court Street. Nick, a lot of emotion out there.
Right, Kristen, that vigil winding down right now, but you can still see some people around, some candles here behind me. This community certainly been shaken by the loss of four transgender women since last summer, three of whom were murdered. It's why they're standing together this evening to raise awareness and mark their loss. They gathered here for the past hour, sparked by the Sunday homicide of 31-year-old Cache Henderson. Now, she was shot to death inside her apartment that had been set on fire Sunday morning. This community say they're at the point where they're wondering if their visibility is putting them at risk.
And I'm so glad that the news reporter stated that the murderer of her got arrested immediately, like almost overnight. Wait, y'all at now, black people? Don't get quiet now. You wanted us to march for George Floyd and what the other girl name was, Sandra Bland and all that, and Breonna Taylor. Another one of our own has passed just because she trans. Don't disclone her now. But staying on the topic of incarceration, we have to talk about Demi Minor. Unfortunately, Demi has been the person in question, seeming as we in Milwaukee, we're going to jump back to the East Coast of New Jersey, of how she was placed in an all-women's prison. A lot of people didn't like that because she was trans, and, you know, whether she identified after she did the crime because she didn't want to go to a male jail, or whether she already has, she has had the F on her driver's license. Unfortunately, she's sparked up some, you know, hoopla because she impregnated two of the inmates up in there. She has not been, you know, given any sort of leniency on her sentence. Is very sad. I mean, it's real. This is real life. And, you know, we're just going to keep y'all updated on the sentencing for that. And piggybacking off of her in jail, y'all know Nikita Dragun last year was in jail, and she wasn't in the female vicinity or general pop or isolation. She was with the men. And this is going back to Miami, Florida. She got in and out, though. It wasn't like she really served any time. She just was probably in holding for, you know, acting belligerent. And, you know, putting, like, I think she splashed some water in a police officer's face. She is, you know, I guess, you know, the makeup is running a little low, you know, the well running dry. So instead of, you know, her many hair ventures of wigs and all the stuff she does, she is promoting OnlyFans. So I'm going to play the clip of her promo for that, and we're going to discuss it and get back to some of the resources that are now made for trans people.
Mine's bigger.
So all my homegirls and homeboys of Strawberry Space that are trans, y'all better get up off the couch and get in line to fill out an application at Starbucks, because they are looking like they're a little more inclusive. Yes, y'all, where y'all get y'all coffee from might be the key to gender access. It says Starbucks now, their insurance when you are employed with them covers gender reassignment surgery, so you can finally get that penis or that pussy that you want to. And we are here for it here at Strawberry Space. We're glad somebody accepts us and, you know, has a policy that puts us forward. But unfortunately, for every step up we take, it is 1,000 people that is watching this ready to project the hate on us.
In dealing with transgenderism, it is all or nothing. If transgenderism is true, if men really can become women, then it's true for everybody of all ages. If transgenderism is false, as it is, if men really can't become women, as they cannot, then it's false for everybody too. And if it's false, then we should not indulge it, especially since that indulgence requires taking away the rights and customs of so many.
Cited from ABC and TikTok. Now, Strawberry Space, this is the big kahuna right here. I'm sorry, I couldn't even play the whole speech that Matthew Knowles spoke. The eradication of trans people. I had to look up what eradicate means. Is this what y'all want? I've been trying to stay a little quiet and unbiased and, you know, just have no opinions to make, you know, my visuals and my presentation videos as professional as I can, as with green screen and YouTube will allow me. But on this Strawberry Space, I got to speak. It's no offense to the cisgender people, but what does this come to? Florida lawmakers propose allowing trans kids to be removed from support of parents. What's really going on here? Like, is it seems like there's nothing that will unify faster than your hate for the LGBT community. And I felt like I was really going against the grain, because I felt a lot of people felt if, you know, they disagree with us, they were deemed transphobic and they couldn't say anything, as if the community was silencing them. But now it's like you feel like, okay, we didn't give you an inch, y'all took a mile, y'all done got too much power, and we got to put y'all back in y'all place. You've seen these articles from them via Instagram, and I'm just speechless. I mean, I cannot believe that you feel as though we as a community are doing so much and just so prosperous, this oppressed people, and now you're trying to simply erase us. And for that, I am just simply shocked, speechless, and lost for words. Now, trans men and trans women of Strawberry Space, y'all not gonna like me after this one. I have to agree with my counterparts in saying this is the definition I feel that some biological cishead people see as doing too much. You, as a follower of God and as a leader of religion, convicted for misgendering a trans person. Now, even I have to say that is kind of a little, you know, it's very excessive. It's not ludicrous. It's not like giving delusional, but it's just kind of, you know, taking it too far. I understand you have been shunned and you have been put in a corner so much of your life to now where you have the power to fight back. I just feel like you're doing it in a way that is not suitable to your cause. I'm trying to step on eggshells and sugarcoat as much as I can, you know, because we just want to be as cautious with our words here at Strawberry Space with people's feelings as possible. But I do feel like they need to free whoever the person was in the ministry of the church. I don't feel like that's right, nor do I feel like it is, you know, a representation of all people of the trans community, especially the Black trans community.
A trans woman was stopped from boarding a plane because of her gender.
Before the flight takeoff, they came to us and tore our boarding pass and then said that you are not allowed in our airplane because of the way policies and the airline policies that only male and female can travel, fly the way. It's really hard to digest these things, to digest these words that you are not allowed due to your gender. The airline is only allowed female and male. I guess it's affecting us. It's affecting our mental health. In Pakistan, this 90% flights are connected to the girls' country, so it's now very difficult for the trans community who have extended card to travel all over the world. They should make some pressure on the Gulf countries to just shut down this discriminatory behavior with this transgender community and the full LGBT community.
Story time, all right? I'm at the Atlanta airport, and I just went through the screenings, right? So I guess I buzzed that there was something, you know, something in my pants, right? So they pulled me to the side and I look at the screen and the screen is lit up red and like yellow only on my private parts, okay? My grind area is lit! Okay, and I'm absolutely gagging. So they put me to the side and go ahead and start, you know, hand patting me down and stuff like this. So the lady goes all up and she goes, do you have anything in that area? So I'm like, oh God, I already know. This is my whole penis. Cause she starts checking me up. So she's pulling on my tuck. She goes, man, what's this? Just get your hand off my dick, girl. Let it go. Release it.
So it's really saddening to hear that a lot of my trans sisters have been giving the blues when traveling. I know I personally, me myself, you know, every time I go through TSA, it's always like an issue with, you know, just having your documents in order, mind you now, but it's cisgender people. If your birth certificate still says male, your passport will reflect that as well. But I'm so happy to announce that, you know, they said that this is in the works now for more inclusion metal detectors. So that way when you go through, you know, you won't feel uncomfortable that, you know, the metal detector won't go off for your penis. And hopefully, as far as the other girl in the TikTok video, that more rights will be made so that she can fly on the airline she, you know, prefers with no problem. I would just suggest, you know, maybe a train or a bus in the meantime. And, you know, to really step out on faith. I know that a lot of people are loyal to their country and their values and beliefs, but sometimes what you love does not always love you back. So congratulations are in order for Chanel Hudson. She is the first Black trans co-executive producer of a crime TV documentary. I'm sure y'all know of Peacock, and she did the Casey Anthony story. So a round of applause for her, and we are happy to see another trans woman in a position of power, especially a Black one. So to further celebrate gender fluidity, Sam Smith, which, you know, he has been, I think it's between him and Bad Bunny, on like a don't care, I'm gonna do whatever I want, you know, whole campaign. So he has expressed himself. And let me tell you something, trans men and women of Strawberry Space. And this is a little bit of free game, so I'm dropping this gem on you. The best way to elevate in a cisgender, biological, heterosexual space is through a gay man or a gay woman. I'm telling you, the trans, they can't, something is just non-relatable with that. But the gay, it's been around for years, they can get with that. So they just feel, I guess, that being trans is just too far. So y'all better ride their coattails and, you know, you'll go far. And I'm glad for Kim Petras. I don't know if her name is Petras or Petras. She you know, got on that coattail too. She was with Sam Smith, and congratulations for her for the first openly trans woman to win the Grammy. So she, you know, definitely was on the carpet serving, doing her thing, and she's a cute girl, so kudos to her.
Unholy, Sam Smith and Kim Petras.
Thank you so much. Crazy, Sam, I love you so much. And this song has been such an incredible, incredible journey for me. And Sam has been a supporter of mine for so long. Sam graciously wanted me to accept this award because I'm the first transgender woman to win this award. and I'm so... Thank you. And I just want to thank all the incredible transgender legends before me who kicked these doors open for me so I could be here tonight. Sophie, especially, my friend who passed away 2 years ago, who told me this would happen and always believed in me. Thank you so much for your inspiration, Sophie. I adore you, and your inspiration will forever be in my music. Madonna, for fighting for LGBTQ rights. So much. I don't think I could be here without Madonna. My mother. I grew up next to a highway in nowhere, Germany. And my mother believed me that I was a girl, and I wouldn't be here without her and her support. And everyone who believed in me to this point, I love you so much. The Recording Academy, thank you. This is a huge moment for me. Sam, thank you. You are a true angel and hero in my life, and I love you. And everyone who made the song, too. I love you guys so much. Sorry, I didn't write down the names. I love you. Okay. Bye-bye.
Now, even though that speech was sweet, I don't mean to be the bitter of bad news or correlate some negative dots together, but it was said that, and I hate that, it was no other video of Sam's. It was just the one with him with Kim, that they said now that he's partnered up with her, even though he's already in the LGBT community, that he's supporting the devil. So I don't know nothing about that, but I'm just, you know, here to report the news, so I'm not going to comment, but I'm not going to lie. I have heard that he was practicing some acts at even some concerts. It was all him in red, and like he was in hell and dancing with the devil, and I just hate to see him doing that because, you know, Lil Nas did the same thing, and it really... gives Christian people everything that they need to really just go against us and the community, like as if trans and gay people can't go to church and still be a believer of God. But, you know, Judgment Day is for each and everybody else's, and only one person's name will be in the Book of Life per person, so you can't live for nobody else, and that's just all I got to say. So I don't know if it's called Atlanta or Atlanta or Hotlanta. I don't know, whatever y'all say. But that's where we're going to today. Next, we're almost done. Strawberry Space, I promise. I know this is lengthy, but Keisha Bottoms was the mayor of there. So we was trying to, before, you know, women empowerment and, you know, female suffrage, you got an African-American woman as the mayor. And it would only make sense that since we accepted her, we would accept Angela Stanton. Now, the difference between Keisha and Angela is Angela has a transgender daughter named Jaybiez. Now, it's a long history with her and her daughter, they had went on Dr. Phil. Jaybiez had also went on Hollywood Unlocked with Jason Lee. I will play all those clips. Then it was on BET Plus with her. Then her other daughter, which is Sisgender Imani, had got involved. It was really, really, really messy. I'm always side-eyeing the people who go on, you know, reality TV shows like Karamo Brown and Fix My Life with Ayanla to try to get the, you know, shit resolved. And I'm just like, they secretly low-key gaslighting for the ratings too, but I'm going to go play all that, discuss it, and we're just going to try to dissect it piece by piece.
You don't have to like me or agree what I do, but as a human being, respect is all it really calls for. You don't have to think I'm a woman. That's cool, that's fine. You can think I'm mentally ill, that's cool, that's fine.
I know
fine.
You're mentally ill.
What I was telling you is that I was explaining to her that this is not a mental illness, that there's actually differences within the body for someone that feels the way you do. It's not just in your mind.
But regardless, we have to take a break.
I've been attacked for my social media. I've been attacked for being, a black Republican. I've been attacked for supporting the president that I choose to support. I thought that was all about American freedom. The attacks are not gonna sway my belief. I mean, I just don't believe that a man can ever become a woman or that a woman can ever become a man. It's just, I don't see gorillas out there doing it. I don't see dogs out there doing it. It's just not a part of nature.
Well, JB says her relationship with her mom has been destroyed forever because of Angela's conservative beliefs. And while JB knows that she was no saint growing up, she says her mom was demonic. Now, JB's youngest sister, Imani, says that she's bearing the brunt of Angela's explosive anger. Listen to what she has to say.
I've witnessed a lot of fighting throughout the years between my mother and my brother. And somehow his sexuality was always brought up. My mother is disappointed in how he is presented on the internet. So my mother saw JB twerking and she texted the entire family and basically told us not to support his behavior on the internet. My mother has called my brother derogatory terms in terms of his sexuality as a way to almost condemn his behavior. So my mom is a conservative and she is on the Trump train. We got in a disagreement about abortion and she smacked me because she thought that I was being disrespectful in our conversation about it. She does have an issue with small children being exposed to the gay lifestyle. My mom is worried that I'm influenced by my brother's way of thinking and she's worried that it would rub off on me and that I'll adopt the same mindset. My mom has been an emotional bully to us in the past. She'll tell me that she's the only person that loves me or she's the only person that ever cared for me. My mom will argue with anybody in the family, regardless of if they're a bad child or a good child. She will argue with anyone.
And helping all these other people, why isn't she able to return that love to the person that she created? I guess that's the thing that baffles me. You're 19 years old. You're making at least I've done the math. You're making at least $24,000 a month, at least just on Bigo. You're very intelligent. You're very articulate. You look put together very well. You have an intelligent view on world topics and topics that are very complicated for our own community. Why is it that she's not more proud of you for the person that you become? Is it the gaslighting by the conservative party that wants her to be homophobic? Is she just homophobic, ignorant? I mean, I'm confused.
Okay, so again, getting back into this. Y'all want to hear something crazy? Angela actually has a lot of gay and trans friends. Believe it or not. Angela has a lot of gay and trans friends. She has a lot of gay and trans friends. She just did an interview the other day with Shauna Brooks. Do you guys know who Shauna is?
Yes.
Trans girl.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. So trans girl, she respects her pronouns. She respects.
Oh, get out of here. Are you serious?
Yeah. She respects her pronouns.
Wait.
She used to do.
She responds to Shauna as a she?
Yes. And I can actually, I'm gonna send you this asset. I gotta send y'all this.
Backfired on me. We go on the show. They sticking together, all five of them against me. I'm like, damn, y'all must didn't get the memo. You know what I'm saying? Like, I didn't mean stick together against me. whatever. So I'm on the show. You got Jay and his sister on the bullshit. Monty, you know she gonna ride with Jay. Whatever he say, she on it. So she's sitting there on the side. I'm really trying to kick her out the chair. But I'm like, if I kick her out the chair on the show, then they gonna try to say, you know, child abuse or whatever. But I just, you know, wanted to just bump her ass just, you know, a little bit. You 6'4", you about 400 pounds, your shoulders real broad, your chin spread all the way out here. I see some hair right here on your chest. Like, I know that you're not a woman. So how you gonna try to come to me as a black woman and a mama when I already know you lying off of the rip? Now, I would have had more respect for Mr. Preston if he would have came to me as a child that experienced, right, what he experienced as a child. Man, I could have listened to you then. But the fact that you coming up to, your whole presentation is off, bruh. Your whole presentation is off. Then listen, they end up kicking me off the stage because Mr. Preston want to stand up, come out, he finer than me. Bitch, how? Where? When? Who? Shit. Listen, man, y'all out of y'all mind. So listen, this is what we have to do. I get on Twitter the next day. After the show, I'm sure y'all saw that part. I see when Mr. Preston done put out a tweet saying, hey, I'm going to make sure that I put all of my resources behind JV and his sister to make sure that they pop off. Okay, guess what? Jay grown, but Imani ain't, right? Sir, we don't know you. We don't know you. You a stranger. You a whole 6'4" stalker at this point, and you got a wig on. We don't even know your real identity. You told us Ashley Preston. We don't know what your real name is. We don't know where you're from, none of that. But all of a sudden, you want to come put all your resources behind my children. Now, Jay grown, he gonna do what he want to do, but Imani ain't. So me, I put up on Twitter, I say, y'all know me, y'all know my mouth. You know Jay get it from me. I say, okay. Nigga, if you come anywhere around me and my children, I'm gonna cut your dick off for you. Everybody went to saying I was threatening him. Then they suspended my account saying I was threatening him. I didn't feel like it was a threat. I felt like, you know, it was a warning. Because, you know, usually people put warning signs in their yard. They say, you know, we got a dog. Or they say, if you come in this yard, we're gonna shoot. All I'm telling him is, don't come around my children. Now, what I'm asking is, why is it so bad when I say, I'm gonna cut it off for you, but you, on the other hand, telling my son to cut his off? Now, how is it that you can tell my son to cut his off, but when I tell you I'm gonna cut yours off for you, then now all of a sudden, I'm threatening you, I'm the bad guy, I'm transphobic, so if you cut your dick off, it's cool, but if I cut your dick off, I don't know, I thought I would save you some money. Shit, I don't know. But listen, stop playing with people about their children. Stop doing that. Y'all don't know me. Stop doing that. Now, for the record, I'm gonna say this, and I'm getting ready to end this live, right? I want to let it be known that I don't hate anybody. I don't hate anybody. I think that we should be able to come to a point where we can have conversations, okay? We don't always have to agree, but it doesn't mean hate, okay? Stop trying to make it seem like that's not even healthy for Jaybiez. For those of you all that say that you love him and you support him, stop pushing that agenda that his mama don't love him or his mama don't accept him when he just lost his father. Now, if you don't rock with Jay and you hate Jay, then I expect you to try to use that as something to hurt him. But if you love Jay, you don't want Jay to feel like his daddy gone and his mama don't love him or accept him. That is not true. I absolutely do love Javian. I absolutely do accept Javian, right? Boom Quisha, this new disrespectful motherfucker that I'm seeing that they had on Dr. Field wiggling his ass all across the stage and shit. I don't know who that is. We're going to have to work on that. I don't know where that's going. I don't know. I'm just being honest, okay? But I love and I accept JV and all that other stuff. I don't know if I can handle it. I don't know if I can handle it, okay? I don't know if I can handle it. I don't want my daughters doing it. I got a 17-year-old daughter upstairs right now getting ready to be 17. I got another daughter that's 29. She grown. I don't want to look on the internet and see her. It's just me as a parent, not a hater. Y'all got to stop looking at me like I'm just some stranger just hating on JB. I'm his mama, bruh. I'm his mama. You know what I'm saying? Look at me. The nigga look just like me. I'm his mom. This is not hate. This is a concerned parent, and everybody does not have to agree. It doesn't mean, hey, my mama didn't agree with half of the things that I was doing, but it didn't mean that she hate me. Y'all mamas don't agree with half of the shit y'all doing right now. Some of y'all still hiding your girl clothes in between the mattress. Can't even tell your mama you cross-dressing. Come on, man. Get out of our business. We love each other, right? Don't be listening to all that JB, man. Jay, listen, y'all gonna learn about Jay. Y'all gonna learn about Jay. Listen, I love my son, you know. We have definitely been very disrespectful to each other. There have been times, and y'all know Jay can get disrespectful, and I can too. You know, there have been times in our house, you know, where we have, you know, gotten into bad arguments, gotten into physical altercations, you understand, out of his disrespect. And I mean, it's just that I don't tolerate disrespect from any of my children. It ain't just Jay. It's his sisters. It's his brothers. It's not just him. And I don't deal with the type of disrespect from my other children that I deal with from him, right? I don't have, my other children don't cuss at me. My other children don't call me out of my name. My other children haven't raised their hand at me. JV and I have always, you know, had issues. And I just felt like, you know, JV needed a man in his life. And that's an observation from a mama. Because, you know, if you feel like you a woman and you want to start competing with other women in the house, or you looking at yourself as a woman and you don't know as a man that you're not supposed to fight women, or you're not supposed to put your hands on women because you thinking in your mind that you a woman, that's when it's going too far, right? Like, remember who you are. And if you don't respect your mama, you ain't gonna respect nobody. And that ain't gonna do nothing but backfire. That ain't gonna do nothing but backfire. Oh, this is what I want to address, and then I'm gonna be out of here. This is what I want to address y'all on a serious note. So when Javian's father passed away, right? Javian and I was together. I went and picked Javian up. This is, I think, when me and Javian had this last blow up with the text messages that led to Dr. Phil. I want to give y'all some back information on that. So I went to go pick up Javian. And me and Javian went to the crime scene from where his father was at. And if any of you were watching Javian that day, you know he was, you know, having his moment or whatever, but I was there. And on the way back from the crime scene, he got a text, right? And so he read the text out, and the text said, hey, you know, I'm sending my love and condolences, Phaedra Park. So apparently, you know, his little buddy, Christopher Milan, who's buddies with Phaedra, I guess Phaedra sent this text to Christopher. Christopher sent it to Jay. I don't know what they did. Now, my first question to Jay is, what the fuck, like, why is Phaedra texting you? You know what I'm saying? Because let me tell you something. Phaedra, for one, was supposed to have been Javian's godmom. Phaedra didn't give a damn about Jay. Phaedra ain't never gave a damn about Jay daddy. Phaedra didn't reach out after we got out of prison while we was out there struggling. Like, Phaedra has never given a damn about Javian, his father, or me, right? So my thing is, why is Phaedra texting you? This is what caused this last blow up. Thank you, Christopher Milan. I wish you and your friends, like, y'all know it's beef between me and Phaedra. Y'all know that shit runs deep. I'm talking about it's serious, right? Like, why the fuck you sending my son a text from Phaedra? Like, why would you even do something like that? You know that's going to cause a problem. So this led to me and him, right, having another argument, because I put up on my page, Phaedra, we don't need your condolences. Now listen, y'all know JV and grieving, I'm grieving as well. I was with his father for 21 years. Not in it, it wasn't a boyfriend-girlfriend relationship anymore, but it became more like family. You know what I'm saying? Because we had been co-parenting for so long, his father was like family, right? And his father was someone that had always been there for me. So he and I are both grieving in our own way. So this is what led up to this last outburst, because when I put up the thing on my page about, yo, y'all let Phaedra know we don't need her condolences, he called me talking about, oh, you keeping up all this drama around my daddy death. And if that's the case, I don't need neither one of y'all. Just getting real Javian, getting real, real nasty, real, real disrespectful. And one of the last conversations I had with Javian's father before he passed, because Javian's father was trying to patch things up between he and I, because we had been in a rough patch. And Javian, he was saying that he had been telling Jay, you know, you're not going to get no blessings, you know, for disrespecting your mama. You know, you got to respect your mama, man, and to cut your life short if you don't respect your mama. So I know that there was a stream of text that you all saw between me and Javian, where I'm telling Javian in the text, I'm like, listen, you're not going to live long disrespecting your mom. I said, your life's going to get cut short, just like your dad's, right? I said that in the text. When I said that, which I was wrong for saying it at that time, shouldn't have said that, people took it the wrong way. I wasn't saying it like, aha, that's why your daddy did. I was trying to tell him that his father losing his life was an exact example of that. Like, one of the reasons why I left his father was because of the way his father disrespected his own mother and what I had witnessed, right? Of course, they got better over the years, but I was his father's first, like, got him out of his mom's house. And I saw him disrespect his mom, and it made me no longer wanted to be with his dad. And not only that, you know, his daddy, he changed over the years, but his daddy never really had no respect for any of the women that he was with. And I ain't here to talk down on him, because he was his dad, and, you know, he did the best that he could, and he was there, and he was a provider. I ain't got nothing bad to say, but I was trying to explain to Javian in that text, like, it, disrespecting your parents, it will cut your life short. And Javian released those texts and tried to make it seem as if, you know, that I was making it seem like, aha, your daddy did. You know, I was just as hurt as him, you know, still hurt. So I just wanted to explain that and kind of clear it out after air. Now, on Dr. Phil, y'all are going to see me snap, because Javian gave these people some text messages. This how you know they clout chasing. Javian gave these people some text messages way back from December before his father passed away. And I'm telling him in these text messages, Jay, go bond with your daddy, right? Get off my motherfucking back, nigga. Go bond with your daddy. This is what I'm telling him, because his daddy had just come home from prison. Do you know they done took these text messages, right? Retext them on their own platform and put the date on there 2 days after JV and daddy died. Like, they literally tried to set up this scene to make it seem as if I'm telling this man to go bond with his daddy after his daddy got murdered. This is the games that they playing on Dr. Phil. So I think we both gonna do a live, you know what I'm saying? But I just want people on here to know, that's watching, that came in to tune in today, to listen, to know that it's not the hate that they trying to portray. That shit is all a fucking agenda. Y'all know that I'm in politics. I run campaigns. Don't nobody hate my son. I do not hate my son. I love him. But all that, y'all trying to force Boom Quisha on me, that's not going to work. But thank you all for tuning in today. We'll see what's going to happen. All the haters, all the love, all the people that show me love.
All right, y'all, I was debating whether to put an emoji over my face. This is like 2004, 2005-ish. Strawberry space, trans men and women. This is me before I transition with my dad. Just to give you some relatability to this story before I make my thesis statement. My dad, when I transitioned, was kind of a lot like one of the lives that I couldn't record because there was not enough space on my iPhone storage with, you know, Angela and JB's. So Angela was crying because she said in addition to her Dr. Phil interview, that she feels that she, meaning JB's, feels like she doesn't have a mother. And Angela says, well, I feel like I don't have a son. I understand a lot of parents feel that we are taking away the child that they dreamed and wished, conceived and prayed for, known and loved. But I do want to say, in addition to that, that we, and not as gay or trans, we just as people, okay, cannot continuously, you know what I'm saying, stress over and think about someone else's feelings over our own actions. Because if so, let me ask my grandpa, how did he feel about my dad marrying my mom? He didn't ask my dad for permission. He didn't ask my dad how he, you know, well, before I do X, Y, and Z, let me just check in with you. No. Empaths don't do that either. No one does that. I understand how you feel and what you're saying. I'm not a parent. I never understand, probably never will. But what I will understand is the fact that you have a warm, safe home, a couch, a bed for this individual. Why would you endanger your child by kicking them out into the world, forcing them to suicide, sex work, and all else? Well, you could just keep them safe where they're at. Instead, feeling like we're self-sabotaging ourselves when really it's you that brought us into danger. I could just apologize 1,000 times on behalf of anybody that might be experiencing this on the other side as a parent. But like I said, if you know your children, you know. And what kills me is you know that people have African-American community, especially their run-ins and violence with the community before we do, because you're older than us and it's like you see it coming. Why not just hinder it by just nipping it in the bud? But instead, you contribute right to the cause and throw people right in the line of fire. I mean, love their child or not, some people, it's not a requirement. Some people, you know, they're like, hey, this is my family. You know what I'm saying? I'm going to be with them whether they call me it or not. I guess it all depends upon how important your transition is to you towards your parents. If you could just hang around, you know, at every reunion, at every picnic outing, and family gathering, and have everybody, you know, dead name you, and still be comfortable within yourself, knowing who you are, that's you. Because, you know, some people, Strawberry Space, see that as disrespect, and they're like, no, I fought to be who I am. You know, my name on my birth certificate, my driver's license, social has changed. I'm a new person. The person that you thought you knew, you didn't know. And if you didn't know, you didn't know me. And you're disrespecting me by referring to the person that I was. Even though you birthed me, you named me, you had me. That was you, you know, in your envision of me. I'm my own person. So it's kind of like, you know what I'm saying? I can write the own script for my life, you know? And I mean, you can only but understand and accept it, because is your mom and dad cool with everything you do? Oh, okay. So, I mean, I'm trying to find the right words to say, because, you know, it hurts everybody in this situation. And I understand, but, to try to guilt trip and gaslight an individual who has made their own mistakes, who has made their own sins, their own actions that their parents have not agreed with, and to say that you don't agree with who I am because it feels like that you're grieving the child, you want your child back. You want the relationship back. And now because you can't have that back because of the life, due to the lifestyle, you are to ostracize yourself from me. That is where I can't. I understand where Angela had referenced the Bible. Oh, I know it very well. I've been at the church. Honor that father, that mother for that long. You know, life shall live. So she was right when she said, you know, you're cutting your days short. But in addition to that, what days of yours are going to be in heaven with you treating your child like that? And like JB said, whether trans or not, man or not, we are human beings. And the way that you treat us will come back on karma full circle. That's why Jaybiez is making so much money on Biko. She has been accepted into the House of West. She is in ballroom and she is thriving and heavenly flourishing, you know, with or without her mom. So in addition to that, she was seen doing a TikTok with her mom. And, you know, it's nice to see that they obviously let bygones be bygones and, you know, move forward.
Question. Why can't we leave trans people alone? Let them be who they are. Let them live their lives. Let's stop discriminating against them simply because they are different from who we are and different than what we understand. Just because we don't understand it doesn't mean we shouldn't support the transgender community and love them in the same way we should love all human beings. They're not bothering anyone. They want to go to school. They want to play sports. They want to hang out with their friends. They want to live their lives. Let them live their lives. We have an ugly history of discriminating against people who are different than we are throughout our time in this country. Whether they are Black, Latino, Asian, LGBTQ, poor, people with disabilities, women. We have an ugly history of discrimination in this country, and now the trans community is the target. All they want to do is live their lives. Why are Republicans so uncomfortable with this? Let them be who they are. That's it. They're not bothering you. They're not criminalizing your communities. They're not engaging in gun violence. They just want to live and be happy like everyone else.
So y'all heard Democratic of New York Congressman Jamal Bowman. And I really do feel like the message was highly received because it wasn't coming from someone who was gay and it wasn't coming from someone who was trans. So I feel like because it did not affect him and it wasn't like biased towards him, a lot of people heard what he had to say. And I loved at the end where he said, and they just want to be happy like everybody else. Period. Okay? Because that's what we want. To be happy just like everyone else. Y'all heard what he said. So, in conclusion, I know this has been a long video. If y'all have stayed with me, I know I've talked y'all ears off, but this has been Strawberry Space, and thank you.